Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learning Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1497, Sheets Revisited. We're going to go back to episodes 1488 and 1489. Those generated a lot of email. I was trying to make copies of sheet 1, and I did that by holding down control and dragging to the right. And a few people, or CarpyJedi wrote in and said, well, do that a few times. Select the first sheet, shift-click the last sheet, make sure you go back to the first sheet, hold down the control key, and drag that whole thing to the right. Now you're knocking out five sheets at a time instead of one at a time. Good idea. Next, OS Mr. Ducks in Denver said, oh, hey, here's a cool trick, because in 1489, I then had to rename those sheets. Start with day, and as you make copies, the second one will be called day 2, day 3, day 4, day 5, and then when you get done, go back here and rename this one to be day parentheses 1. And you're good to go that way, all right? Clever, clever, I like that trick. And then ASD just, it was a one-line reply. Macro? Well, of course macro, that's the way to go. In a past podcast, we talked about the fill handle sheets, which is like, take this day one and pretend that you put day one here, grab the fill handle and drag, and you know it will fill. Why can't the sheet copy automatically do that? Well, I wrote a macro, Control Shift F. How many sheets do I want? I want 30. Click OK, and it goes through and uses that fill handle logic to rename the sheets. Here, let's try this one. Let's call this one Monday, and Control Shift F. How many new ones do I want? I want 6. Click OK, and bam, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. So that code. Code is here. Let's just take a look at how this is working. If you want the code, shoot me a note, bill@MrExcel.com. It actually figures out how many sheets do you want. It figures out the name of that sheet and creates a brand new workbook. It hides the screen so you can't see it. Creates a brand new workbook, puts that sheet name in, and then uses the fill handle to copy it down. And then for each item in that new sheet, it is adding a worksheet to the end and using the cell from that new sheet, and then closes that temporary sheet. So kind of a little bit of code there. I suppose if we had a specific list, it would be easier, but it's an interesting way to go through. So lots of good responses there to 1488 and 1489 making sheet copies. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast. Mr. Excel.